Greetings, fellow Woodlands. Welcome back to 13. We are continuing with the main story. Thus far, we have uncovered that we are, in fact, an assassin of some sort who has been hired to assassinate President Kennedy.
I've got a Class A hero mission on.
Okay, so yeah, apparently, I don't know whether it was JFK or not, but it was some president or somebody. And to tie up loose ends, the people who are... who have hired us are now trying to essentially get rid of us to tie up loose ends. So we wake up on the beach with no recollection of what happened before this, and all we can do is just, you know, try and figure out who we are, piece together things, and to that extent we have found a key that we can use at a certain bank. So that's where we're headed. So let's go ahead and start this thing.
Mr. Roland?
Yes, indeed.
It's been such a long time.
Hasn't it?
I assume you want to access your safe?
Yes, I do.
May I have your key?
Absolutely.
Right this way, please.
Now, for the sake of full disclosure, this is a post-gameplay recording.
As you can see, we've upgraded our security system. You can't be too careful in today's world, right?
That's true. Now, the thing is, this game has a weird thing with saves, and my audio
Hello,
in the original...
James. Mr. Roland would like to access his safe.
Hello, Mr. Roland.
The audio
it's
in the...
still at the far end of the room.
Could you guys shut the fuck up for 2 minutes? Thank you. Now, the audio in the original recording was quite garbled, distorted,
Surely,
so to speak.
When you're ready to come out.
Yeah, sure. So yeah, I went ahead and I had to redo this level again anyway because of the save system in this game, and I'll get that later. If I have the time for it, but yeah, so this is a post-gameplay recording. I thought I might as well record a post-gameplay commentary on this.
Right. They took the bait. That's the motherlode right there. The 20 would kill to get their hands on those files. We'll incriminate all of them, from number 20 to number 1. What are you planning on doing on that boat? Confidential, huh? Oh, I get it. Well, if it's another one of that girl's ideas, I'd watch her six. She's nothing but trouble. Go ahead, set the bomb.
So I'm basically framing myself at this point, and this is the part of the story where the plot thickens, so to speak. But at any rate, we run over to the, you know, other side to avoid the explosion, otherwise it docks like half your health points. And then we run. We run all the way up the stairs, and
I've fallen into my own trap.
It's essentially a long section where the next part of the game loads, where you keep running. Now this is the part where the game introduces itself to us, and the first guard here,
well,
you don't really
well.
I don't get the security system. How do you lower the gates?
Yes, with the first guard, you don't really need to knock him out. You can just bypass him entirely. Now, this game has a pretty simplified stealth system. Then again, after playing Splinter Cell, all stealth games probably seem pretty simplified. But, yeah, the stealth system in this game is pretty simple. You need weapons to knock people out with one hit. You can't exactly do that with your hands. You'll need like a few hits on them, even if you're doing it from behind them. to knock them out using just your hands, and you tend to lose health in the process. This first guy, you just walk around him, to be honest. He's pretty easy to fool. He's not really looking at you.
Don't panic! Please, stay calm!
Does not look at you, actually. I mean, it's pretty difficult to be detected by him. This guy, on the other hand, alongside the rest of the people that you're going to encounter here on out, they tend to see you pretty easily. So, the cues here are to look at the tap sounds. You won't actually get audio feedback. You have to look at the tap sounds and how large they appear on the screen. That'll tell you whether the guards are coming towards you or going further away. So, I mean, a pretty unique approach. I feel like it blends well with the comic aesthetic. Like, in this case, the guard notices me, and I was trying to get past him without him noticing me, but I could not really do that. This is one of the guards that you absolutely have to take out, as far as I've noticed. This next guy, however, he's gonna come and he's gonna stand at the balcony right here. And when he starts moving away, when he starts heading towards us, he's gonna hide here, and when he starts heading towards us, he also does not notice us, is when we're gonna make a break for it. So this guy was in on the plan. The banker, I mean. And that's a cop coming towards us. I don't know whether that's a cop or whether that is a guard of the bank itself, but it seems to be a guard on his payroll, I suppose. Because otherwise, he probably would not be incriminating himself. Unless the police is involved in this as well, the local police, I mean. Now, that's a logo of the organization that we work for. Again, the taps are receding, so we can essentially move away. This guy, however, I could not find a way to get past him without knocking him out. You either need to knock this guy out or the guy on the other side of the room. No real way to get past him. Yeah, he just notices you anyway. We take a few shots there. Pick up the health pack, break that, end up going through, but we get noticed by the other guard as well, and he shoots at us. Finally, we have this woman here.
If this robber would just take a hostage, then we could shut the damn thing off.
Well, your wish is about to come true. Now, yeah, it's pretty simple, pretty set, a very set structure to this level. You take her as a hostage, and then you essentially use her as a shield to get to the exit. I mean, the stealth in this game, they have introduced stealth, and I suppose Ubisoft was into making stealth games, and I suppose they still are, because they keep making stealth games one after the other. But one of the things that I've never really understood about this game is why you need to equip a key to use it first. But however they want to handle it. Back off, bitch. Come on, back off. Good job. So if you have your backs back turned to them, they will shoot you. We don't need this hostage anymore, so we just choke her unconscious.
Hey you! Freeze! Drop the piece!
And that's basically the guy that we... One of the guys sent to stop us, called in by the banker over there. We can enter this room on the left to grab a shotgun. The shotgun in this game, although, works very strangely. Now, as I was saying about the save games in this level, in this game actually, you only save at checkpoints. So, checkpoints are placed at the beginning of the level. So, if I want to capture a cutscene, I need to do it at the end of every level. I cannot really, you know, capture it at the very beginning of the level, which is something that I remembered. So I pretty much had to play through the very first level and through this level just to get to level 3. Thankfully for me, the levels in this game are pretty short, so I didn't have to play a lot to get to where I wanted to get, so that I could capture the damn cutscene. And I'll just have to keep a mental note of things. We take the right here. That's this way. That is their point of intrusion. And after this, we just head downstairs.
Central, this is Car 5. The unit is already at the scene.
Copy
they get caught by the police.
FBI, drop your weapon!
Steve Rowland, you are under arrest for the murder of William Sheridan.
I am?